Hello everyone, welcome to this video on the 5 most important tips on getting started with the Unreal MCP server. Now, even though this MCP server is still in an experimental stage, the whole point of this video is to help you get started so that you can go ahead and make use of it for your own creations. Now, without further ado, let's get started. Alright, so the most basic thing that you want to do is to be able to spawn actor within the world. So you can say, spawn a static mesh actor in the world. Static mesh actors are the most basic actors that you can find in Unreal. And you can see, once it's done this, it says it spawned a static mesh actor, and you'll be able to find it over here. And once it's there, you will be able to then change it to anything that you want. So let's just change this to a cone, right? And there you can see it is updated to a cone. You can then change other things about the actor. So you can say, move the actor higher up in the sky, and this will then be able to translate it. And here you go, it's moved up further up in the sky. So this is just a showcase of some very basic things that you can do. Actually, I would suggest rather than spawning actors in the world, you should be using blueprints. So let's try this differently. Let's create a blueprint for a static mesh and set it to a cone. And what happens is that this will allow you to do more of what we have. Working with blueprints is a lot more flexible because what this is actually going to do is create a file for you, call it BP cone actor. It's also going to be able to modify it for you and set everything for you so you don't actually have to do it manually. As you can see, the blueprint on this side is already updated to a cone. Then it's going to compile it, and this will then allow you to spawn it within the world. So once you have that, you can say, please spawn into the world in the sky. This is a much more flexible way to work within the scene, right? So it's going to spawn this, and let's take a look. There we are. Here it is, up high up in the sky. And so you'll be able to do all the manipulation with it, but then now you can actually say something like, I changed my mind, change the mesh to a cube. Working with blueprints is a lot more flexible because now you can change it from a cone to a cube. And so now once this change happens, you'll be able to see that now your blueprint actor has changed, and then now you can say spawn a new one below the old one. So working with blueprints is a lot more flexible because you can actually use the MCP server to change the properties of the blueprint, and you wouldn't have to do it manually. So there we go. We can see that now we have a cube just below the cone. So that's it for this tip. For the next tip, working with actors is fine, but what you want to do sometimes is that you want to actually create a blueprint that is not just an actor, but has other things like movement controls. So you can say, create a blueprint for the player that is a character. What this does is that it sets a parent class here to character, and what this enables you to do, as you can see, is that it actually now has created a blueprint that already has all the things that you would expect from a character, like a capsule collider and a mesh. You have the capsule component for collisions, you have the movement component to allow it to move. You can actually change the mesh with the MCP as well. And in this case, I said I wanted to have a sphere for a head and cube for its body. Go back to your project. You have the body mesh here. You can see it's going to add the head now. So what you can do here is that now you can go into your blueprint. You can see it has now created a body and a head for you, which is perfect. It has a pretty small head, but that's okay. And finally, the things that you want to do with characters is that you can do something like make it auto-possess. I'm going to show you here. There's this thing called auto-possess, right? It's disabled here, and it's going to now change this to player 0. And that's perfect because what this allows you to do after it compiles it, yeah, is that if you say spawn the character into the world, here you go. It's been spawned right here, right? If you actually press play now, you will actually be the character, right? And this is really important because if, for example, you had left this as disabled and you press play, you will actually not be the character. You'll be a flying camera. So this is actually very useful for you to be the character, and this will allow you to do everything such as movement and controls. Now, talking about movement, the way that you do movement within Unreal Engine is that you go to project settings, and then you go to actions. And basically, you will have different actions that into the input. But rather than doing this yourself, now you can actually say, for my BP player character, I want to have WASD and arrow key inputs. Please add them. And what this will do is that it will actually know that it has to set up these action mappings within the project itself. So you can see here, it's going to create various input mappings. If you go to projects, you can see it's starting to pop up now, right? So you have move forward, which is mapped up to W and S, so forth, forwards and backwards. And then you have another action mapping. You have D for moving right, and you have then A for moving left. And what it can do now is that it can actually add the nodes for you into the blueprint. If you go to event graph, you can see it actually added the pressing forward, and then it's going to add the moving left and right, moving forward and backwards, and moving left and right. These action mappings have been created by the MCP server, including the ability to then wire these things within the event graph itself. Isn't this great? Now, the next thing I'm going to show you is how to actually continue to make changes to your blueprint. Now, if you wanted to change this into a third-person camera, it's actually pretty simple. So you can say, please make my BP player character have a third-person camera in it. And what this is going to do is that it'll actually add something called a spring arm component, or otherwise known as a camera boom. All right, and you can see it here. That's the spring arm. That's where the spring arm is. It's going to set the length of this arm, and then it's going to use the rotation of the pawn. Now, with this in place, it will add the follow camera. You can actually just drop the camera into the boom, right? And this will be where it is. Now, with the camera boom and the spring arm in place, you can change this anywhere you want, right? Maybe you can just tilt it a little bit down, press compile, and because it's already a character, if you press play, now you will be behind the character. And this will allow you to then, you will be behind the character. Now, this tip is going to be slightly different, but I think it's really important. Within the repository itself, I have already included rule files for your different IDEs, including Cursor, Windsurf, Client, and GitHub Copilot. Now, let's take a closer look at what these rules do. So if you're working and building your own tooling, these tools files that you have here are actually very useful because it helps to guide the MCP server to know how to work with Unreal Engine, because sometimes it forgets what the coordinate system is and what the units are, and it ends up pasting things all over the place. If you're using Cursor, this is already set in such a way that it will automatically run whenever MCP calls are made. And this is very useful because this will allow the MCP server to actually be a lot smarter about how it does things within Unreal. And you can add to these rules yourself so that it does things in your way. And if you have any good suggestions on things that I should add by default, please let me know in the comments. Thank you very much for all your feedback and suggestions. I hope that this short video has been useful to give you some tips about getting started with the Unreal MCP server. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to subscribe for the latest updates and the new functionality that's coming in.